So you've decided that for one reason or another, you're going to start looking at a new vehicle, whether that be used, whether that be new. You need a vehicle. So where do you start? With dozens of brands and hundreds of models to choose from, it could be a really daunting task trying to figure out what vehicle is the right vehicle for you and which vehicle should you purchase. Purchasing a new vehicle is likely going to be one of the biggest and most important decisions that you make. So what do you need to consider when you're looking? So the first thing you want to take a look at is, do you want new or pre-owned? And there's benefits to both. So the first thing that you're going to take a look at to determine whether you should buy new or pre-owned is what your budget is, where you want your payment to be, or where you want the overall price of your vehicle to be. That'll help you determine whether or not you're going to be looking at a used vehicle or a new vehicle. After you have your budget set out, the next thing that you need to think about is how long you plan on keeping that vehicle or how long you've kept your vehicles in the past. If you're someone who wants to trade in a vehicle every 3 years, then you need to take a look at what is going to make the most sense. Is it going to make more sense to buy new or pre-owned? Maybe it's going to be pre-owned because the depreciation will work out better and you'll be able to be in a better financial situation 3 years down the road and not absorb so much negative equity when you trade. But if you're someone who wants to keep a vehicle for 9 years, 10 years, or till it just craps out on you, right? If that's the kind of person that you want to be, then maybe you buy brand new and take advantage of 0% interest rate and save more money in the long run, right? So that's another thing that you need to take a look at. The last thing that I want you guys to consider when you're looking at new or pre-owned is warranty. How important is warranty to you? What are the cost of ownerships of these vehicles that you're looking at? What are the common repairs? Are you going to be able to afford to repair something if you buy a used vehicle that doesn't have warranty? Or are you going to feel a lot more comfortable buying a new vehicle and knowing that you have warranty backing up anything that goes wrong with that vehicle for the first 3 to 5 years? The next thing you should consider is, do you want a car, truck, or SUV, right? So what kind of things do you need that vehicle for? Is it going to be your daily driver? Is it going to be a work truck? Are you hauling family members in it? Are you going to get a two-door car, but are you planning on having a family in the next few years or 7 years, and you're going to take out a 7 or 8 year loan? Is that vehicle still going to work for you at that point, right? So you need to consider what kind of vehicle you want. And again, going back to that first question, will that vehicle I want fit into my budget if I want a new one or a used one? The next thing to consider is the type of fuel that your vehicle is going to run on. So do you want a gas, diesel, electric, or hybrid vehicle? Now, when you're thinking about those things, it's important to take a look at, if you're looking at electric or hybrid, where's chargers, stations around where you drive? Is there a charger station on your way to work? Is there one at work? Is there one near your home? All things to consider, right? It's important to take a look at gas mileage, the cost of gas in your area. Is diesel more expensive than gas? Gas more expensive than diesel? Where's the market going? What can I afford? So that's something to consider as well. And the next thing kind of goes with the last one I said, and that is, what is essential? What features are essential? Do you need a 7-seater vehicle? Is that non-negotiable? That's essential. Do you need to be able to tow a certain amount? Do you need a certain length box? Do you need a certain length cab? Do you want four-wheel drive? Do you want Bluetooth? Do you want leather seats? You need to figure out what features are most important to you and what you can live without if those features in the vehicle that you're interested in don't fit in your budget. So once you've gone through all of those questions, you should have a pretty good idea of a couple vehicles that you may be interested in. There may be one that you for sure know is the right one, but you may have a couple different options that you're considering. So in that situation, I always recommend you go to a dealership and test drive each of those vehicles that you're interested in, one after another. You want to go to one dealership, then go to another, then go to another, then go to another. Get all the vehicles that you want to drive driven, because it is super important to see how they handle, see how they drive, make sure you're comfortable in them, check the blind spots, check everything, make sure it's everything that you need. Once you've driven all of those vehicles, one vehicle that you like more than the other is going to be a clear it's going to be clear which one that you're going to want, the one that's going to work best for you. And at that point, you should have also had several run-ins with different salespeople. So hopefully, after test driving some of these vehicles, you found a salesperson that you trust, which is important. You want to make sure that you have a salesperson that you trust. It's going to make the process go so much smoother. And if you build a good relationship with them, they'll be there to help you out even after you purchase the car. So that's another thing that's really important. And the final thing that I want you to consider, once you've picked your vehicle, you know what you want, how are you going to pay for it? Are you going to finance? Are you going to pay cash? Are you going to be doing a lease? If you're going to lease, for how long? If you're going to finance, for how long? What interest rate are you hoping to get? Do you know where your credit stands? All of these things are very important when you're considering a vehicle. What vehicle do you want, and how are you going to pay for it? Now, if you found a salesperson you trust, they should be able to give you all of that information on your options on how to pay without feeling pushy or pushing you into anything. They should be able to give you that information and allow you to make the most informed decision for you on how to purchase the vehicle that you want. So I hope that helped you guys with going through the steps to consider when you're looking at a vehicle. If you guys have any other recommendations or any other questions, don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below. Make sure you subscribe. I put new how-to videos up every Friday. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.